How does the way a poll is conducted influence the answers people give? When you look under the hood of a poll, one thing to notice right away is how people were interviewed, because that can vary widely. For example, in 2016, pre-election polls used at least 5 different approaches. These different ways of asking survey questions are called survey modes. And one of the most intriguing things about survey modes is that they can influence the answers people give. And when they do that, it's called a mode effect. One of the best known mode effects relates to questions that might be uncomfortable to talk about with an actual live stranger, whether it's on the phone or face to face. For example, what's your annual income? Did you vote in the most recent election? Have you ever been addicted to prescription drugs? People tend to give more honest, accurate answers to sensitive questions like these when there isn't an actual live person asking the questions. To give you a feel for this, let's look at an experiment Pew Research Center conducted where half the participants were asked to take a survey online with no interviewer, and the other half were asked to take a survey by phone with an interviewer. When asked about their personal financial situation, 20% of those polled online admitted to being in poor shape financially. That compares with 14% of those polled on the phone. Now that 6-point difference is a mode effect, and it suggests a bit more honesty, more reporting of financial distress when there's no interviewer involved. Other questions in that same experiment asked about topics where there is no socially correct or socially desirable answer. For example, views on the 2010 healthcare law showed no bill difference. It got a 48% approval rating online and also on the phone. The takeaway is that if the question is straightforward and it's not sensitive, you're unlikely to see very different results from different modes. And while the concern about interviewers gets a lot of attention, that's actually not the only way that measurement can differ between modes. For example, there's a tendency in the online surveys for people to slightly favor the first answer choice presented because they're reading and that's the option that they process most intensely. But in phone polling, it's the reverse. In phone polling, there's a slight tendency for people to favor the last answer choice because they're listening. That's the one that the interviewer just read to them, so it's a little bit easier to remember. At Pew Research Center, we survey the public using both telephone interviewing and online surveys. And so it's important for us to understand how the survey mode might be influencing people's responses. Typically, mode effects are fairly small, especially for opinion polling. But they're important to keep in mind when trying to understand why polls sometimes get slightly different results.